Welcome to my review of the 1/6 scale director krennic figure made by Hot Toys. As you see, the box here looks beautiful. On the bottom of the box is a nice band with director krennic right there in red and white. And if we look on the other side, there's a picture of his face of the figure. On the other side, the same thing. And we look on the back here as all the credits of who made this figure. Now let's open up this box here and look at all the accessories and the figure himself. Our first accessory we're looking at today is the rain poncho. As you see, it looks beautiful, the details look wonderful, and as you can tell, it's not all white, it's more of a cream color, which is accurate to the film. You can't really tell or notice in the final film, but it is close to this color. But as we look up more closer there, especially with the rank bar, just the details look beautiful. Now, let's go to the hands here. He doesn't come with a lot of hands, which is very disappointing. And I feel like they're a little bit off too in the size and the sculpt. These hands could have been a lot better. Now let's move on to his blaster. I see the blaster looks beautiful. The details really well done and the paint job is fantastic looking, especially too with the wood detailing of the grain. Looks wonderful and the shining metal on the blaster. It just makes it look more realistic looking and more, should I say, Star Wars looking of a blaster. But yes, a beautiful looking blaster for the director. And here's the base for director krennic. As you can see, it's a nice looking base, and I do love the picture that's on top, but unfortunately though, it's not removable. Now, it can be removable if you gently pull it up, but you have to be very gentle with it. But overall though, it's not a bad looking base overall, I think. And as you see right there on the corner, there's a Star Wars basic that says Orson Krennic. And also to the nameplate as well, says Orson Krennic too. Lots of other fans or collectors has a problem with that as well. They wish it says Director Krennic, which I'm in the same boat. But overall, Orson Krennic is still a fine nameplate. Here's the hat for the director himself, which is a beautiful detail hat. I'm very happy they went with plastic and not tried to go with cloth, or else it might turn out not as great as it did here. As you see on the bottom, there is a magnet so they can switch out the hair sculpt. Now here's the figure all in full. As you see, he's looking wonderful there. We're going to go in more details of the costume and his little parts he has on the costume. But first, let's take a quick look at that beautiful head sculpt of director krennic slash Ben Mendelsohn. And here's an up close look at the head sculpt. And as you see, Hot Toys did a fantastic job. They always knock it out of the park with old man figures or old people figures or head sculpts, I should say. And as you see, this is no exception. This looks just like Ben Mendelsohn in every corner, every angle you look at him. He looks wonderful. Now, there is a little seam line problem in his hair, just a little bit, but it's not that much of a problem though, I feel like. You can't really notice it unless if someone points it out to you. Now, we're looking more around the head sculpt of this figure, and every time I move him around, he just looks so beautiful. Especially, look at that hair sculpt there. That looks wonderful with all this detailings of each strand of hair. That's just mwah, wonderful looking. And let me turn him around here again just to show you a little bit more of the director. And this right here, this pose right here, this is 100% director krennic without a doubt. Every time you look at this sculpt, he looks just like director krennic. We move down now to more of his chest area to show off his cold centers right there and there, and his rank bar. Now the rank bar is not painted that well. All the squares should be fully painted, but Hot Toys only did the very top part, and it's not very well painted because some of the silver is still showing through underneath of the blue and red, but it's okay because it's from the original trilogy. It can be like, hey, it's a bit worn or torn down just a little bit, like how the rest of the original trilogy was, so I can take or leave. And also too, you can't really tell the details of that when you're looking at the figure from your display. And also too, let's talk about the costume itself. beautiful costume job that Hot Toys did here. It looks just like from the film. Just every stitch is perfect. Way much more better than the Tarkin, in my opinion, of the Imperial Officer uniform. Now we're gonna go talking about the belt. First thing we're gonna talk about are these ammo holsters for his blaster. Now these ammo holsters are great and they're very movie accurate, but the problem is the hole is just too tiny for these to go in properly. You really have to force them down to get them stay in there. But once they stay in there, they look great. And now we are turning around the figure here a bit just to show you more of the belt here and his holster that holds his, well, blaster. As you can see, the detailing looks nice, just like from the film. Every detail is perfectly correct to Rogue One, of the belt detailing and down to the holster shape of how it holds his, well, blaster. And here are his officer pants, which look wonderful, very nice and pointy and sharp looking, like it was in Rogue One. Now here is his officer boots. As you see, they look wonderful. Now you might think they're just the same as the Dooku, Vader, Han, and all of the rest, but they're not, because Hot Toys actually pay attention to the details by adding the buckle up on the very top there that Director Krennic only has. He's the only Imperial officer that has that buckle detailing up there. Now let's talk about the cape a bit more. I think Hot Toys did a great job on the cape, but I want to talk about more of the wire that's on the bottom here. Now, lots of collectors are a little bit worried about this wire. Why are they worried, you might ask? Well, it's a copper wire, but that's not the only thing. It's a copper wire inside a white cape. Now, that can cause staining issues maybe down the road, so lots of collectors have been removing the wires on the bottom of this cape. I have not yet because I'm a little bit too afraid to do so, but I might do it in the future. But for now, I'm going to leave it like this, but if I see any staining, and if you ever see any staining, just a little bit on your Director Krennic, I definitely suggest you remove the wires immediately. So then your figure's cape, or basically your whole figure basically, doesn't get ruined. But for now, I'm gonna take the risk and just leave the wires in for now because I don't want to accidentally, well, destroy the cape. But overall though, Hot Toys did do a fantastic job with this Director Krennic cape. I think one of their best. So what's my overall thoughts on this figure? He is beautiful looking. The details are really, really well done and movie accurate to Rogue One. And the head sculpt is 100% Ben Mendelsohn. It is beautiful looking. Now, unfortunately though, this figure does have a little bit drawbacks. One being the hands. Now, the hands are fine, but there's not as many of them as there should be. And I do believe that the poses of the hands could have been done better. And also too, like I mentioned with the seam line, just a little bit in his hair, that's our downside. And also too, with the wire copper in the cape itself. Now, I have no problem with it, but I didn't see it being a problem down the road. But those are the only three really concerns and negatives I really have with this figure. Overall though, I say don't pass on him. He's not a sleeper. Get him while you can, because if you don't, you're definitely going to regret getting the great and powerful Director. Well, maybe not powerful, but the great Director Krennic.